Coupang is most often compared to Amazon. It has an outsized share of its local e-commerce market, a similar efficiency at all costs business model, and a host of highly automated fulfillment centers like this one in Daegu. Its newest and largest, 3.5 million square feet of floor space spread out over 12 stories. Think nearly 50 football stadiums stacked on top of each other and side by side. But its size is not its only signature. It stands out for its AI-driven army of robots. From heavy hauling merchandise movers to driverless forklifts and scurrying sorters that navigate by QR codes in the floor and on pillars that get 99% of all orders delivered within a day. All this speed to customer has come at a cost. Coupang, backed by Japan's SoftBank, has burned through cash, losing billions, building more than 100 fulfillment and logistics centers across South Korea with more planned. This one cost $250 million.
We've invested billions of dollars to really building this network that is integrated in between all the logistics steps in the supply chain.
And how important is it that Coupang is end-to-end? So you have the e-commerce, you have the fulfillment, and you have the logistics, the delivery.
You know what, that's our actual differentiator with our competitors, right? Because we own and operate the entire process.
Still, investors remain cautious, as shares have lost two-thirds their value since Coupang's post-New York IPO high in March of 2021.
Every tech company around the world now is talking about saving the cost. Coupang probably is one of the few tech company that is still adding headcounts.
We're actually third largest employer in Korea, and we continue to hire people, but their job becomes more easier and becomes more like a controller type of task. We have these sorting boats that are basically eliminating all of the carrying and most of the lifting involved in conventional sortation
processes. So you've removed all the heavy lifting, haven't you?
Exactly.
Going forward, the real heavy lifting might be in its plans to go overseas, where they currently have only minor footprints in Taiwan and Japan.
Global expansion is not very easy. This market is already very crowded. A lot of companies like Amazon, Alibaba, even TikTok wants to do its own e-commerce.
For now, the focus seems to be on this factory floor, not future ones further afield.
These forklifts are equipped with a vision technology that looks at these marks and knows exactly their locations and where they need to move to.
And they always obey.
They do. It's a machine. It's a programmable, so.
They do what you tell them to
yes.
do. Got it.
All right, let's bring in Steve, who joins us now from Daegu. Steve, great to have you, and just such interesting visuals, right? What was kind of the standout element to you in terms of what you saw?
Well, I think it's these sorting bots that are behind me, that kind of scurrying around. It's kind of the last mile of the organization chain here in the fulfillment center before the packages go on to the trucks. And essentially, they get navigated around this area by QR codes that are in the ground or in the floor. They don't run into each other because it's all pre-programmed. And according to EJ Choi, who we spoke to yesterday, they don't have any mishaps, and that helps reduce the human error and, of course, improves that efficiency. So this is part of that speed-to-customer equation that has helped Coupang turn to an operation profit in the calendar third quarter, and most analysts say in the fourth quarter likely to have a second consecutive profitability and perhaps even turn to break even on a net basis sometime this year. They are adding active users. They were up 7%. They also had a 10% increase in net revenue. But again, there are some still challenges on the horizon. Of course, as they're still in a big investment phase, they're going to be building out several more of these large fulfillment centers. As you said, this was about $260 million. More on the way. The goal really is to get the goods to consumers as fast as possible. And they have more than 100 of these across South Korea, not as large as this one. They have fulfillment centers and logistics centers. centers, but 70% of South Koreans are within 7 miles of a distribution center like this one, so they get the goods to people quickly. But again, as we said, they've spent billions to build out this automation, which is improving efficiencies, it is improving top and bottom line, but again, there's concern about the big parent, SoftBank. We've been talking about it, earnings coming out later. They did divest some of their stake in Alibaba, the bigger e-commerce competitor in China. But again, there might be some concern that they could divest some of their 27% stake that they have in this company, Coupang.
Are there any plans to reach the international consumer at some point?
Well, that's a big challenge because right now in South Korea, Coupang has about 25, 26% e-commerce market share. There's competitors here, obviously. Everybody wants a part of the e-commerce pie here. Naver, the search engine, is a big rival. Shinsegae, the department store operator, they want to do more in e-commerce. So there's a lot of competitors. So at 25%, they still have a lot more room to grow in the Korean market, obviously. You know, Amazon has about 50% in the United States. Alibaba has about 50% in China. So there's room to grow. So international expansion is more of a challenge. There's different logistics and delivery systems, and building a fulfillment center in another country like Japan, which they are having a beginning footprint, and also in Taiwan. It's just the beginning, but I think there's still more room to grow here in South Korea.